the phone is Pennsylvania Senator Vincent Cuomo. We're sorry to be interrupting his dinner. And from our CNA Philadelphia studio, Bill Kearney, a former gambling addict and the author of Comped, about the roller coaster ride of the casino lifestyle. Thank you both for being here.
Thanks for having me.
You're welcome.
Senator, before your food gets cold, let me go to you. One of the things that a GAO study found about legalizing gambling is that some crime rates, including total crime, property crime, embezzlement, and prostitution, increased immediately in places where they legalized it. Is Pennsylvania prepared to up the policing to see that this doesn't happen there?
Well, we're prepared to do that, but I don't think we're going to experience a sharp rise, a sharp increase in those crimes, because all around us and all of our borders, there is gambling going on. In fact, probably one half of Atlantic City's revenue comes from Pennsylvania. So we're experiencing the problems that some gamblers would do with embezzlement and things of that nature. In fact, I am the chairman of the board of a bank, and when gambling first came to Atlantic City, we experienced embezzlement with some of our younger tellers, and we didn't even have gambling in Pennsylvania. So I think we were already suffering the social ills of gambling because of its close proximity on our borders, and our view was if we're going to be having to suffer that, we might as well at least get the revenue from it on the flip side.
Mr. Kearney, you have a number of suggestions that you think any states that legalize gambling should take up, and one of them would somewhat address some of those issues of fraud. You, for instance, don't want them to have ATM
right,
things and credit there at the casinos.
But, you know, it's awfully strange when you hear Senator Cuomo talk about the crime that we've already experienced, that his own bank experienced from Atlantic City. I mean, doesn't anyone wonder why you would want something like this in your state? And the funny part about it, and what's going to happen in your state also, when the casinos, there's going to be two of them right here in Philadelphia. And right now, Philadelphia is the largest city in the country to host the gaming industry. And when these two casinos open up here, the people who are going to use it are going to be the people, the blue-collar workers out of South Philly, Southwest, West, North, Northeast Philly. These are the people who are going to be in these joints day after day, week after week. It's not going to be the representatives, the governor, his family, and their family members using this product.
One of the things that a lot of the studies look at is the problem of the addicted or pathological gambler, but we don't regulate all of alcohol sales because of the handful of people that have alcohol problems. One of the things that you think we should do to help stop the compulsive gambler is stop comps.
Right. Well, first of all, look, no industry in this country can get away with what this industry gets away with. Number one, can you name one industry that serves free alcohol beverages while doing business? Now, Mr. Senator Cuomo's in the banking business. I'm sure he's not allowed to get somebody loaded when he's writing up a mortgage or lending people money. And when he talks about it being so close, Atlantic City is still an hour and a half from Philadelphia. Now, when the casinos, 40 minutes, but now what's going to happen to the construction guy, the roofer, on days like today, the rainy days that we get in this area, the bad weather days, when he's hanging out in the bar blowing 50, shooting pool, and buying beer. Now he's going to be in these joints because the availability is going to be here.
Senator Cuomo, let me throw it back to you. He makes a good point that if I came in to your bank and signed a mortgage loan, but the whole time I was looking at all the different instruments, you were feeding me highballs and screwdrivers, and I signed a really bad deal, wouldn't I be able to come back to you later and say, wait a minute, I want my money back?
You probably would be able to, but, you know, we had a situation like that with Leonard Toews, who used to own the Philadelphia Eagles, where it was alleged that they got him drunk in Atlantic City and lost his fortune. He sued, and the courts found that that was not the case. But I think you brought up the most important point. I can't regulate 99.5% of the population because of a problem of 0.5% of the population.
Senator Vince Cuomo, thanks for joining us. We'll let you go back and enjoy your steak. And Bill Kearney, thanks for trying to help out some folks that may need your help.